Hello, everyone, and welcome to Faro Sports Update. I'm your host, Rob Bentley, and thanks for tuning in. A busy fall sports season is underway. Today, we'll talk Bulldog football. We'll also check out the women's soccer team, and we'll find out what's going on in Bulldog cross-country action. First, let's welcome head coach Jeff Pierce of the Bulldog football team. Coach, welcome to the show.
Great to be here, Rob.
Coach, you've played a couple games already this season, a couple close games, both decided by 3 points, and really a couple games where a play here or there could have changed the outcome of either game.
Yeah, we've had an opportunity to kind of judge and find out where we are as a football team. We opened up with two very good football teams, Hillsdale being a nationally ranked team, and ended up beating Grand Valley last weekend, and we were able to battle through that football game and come back and win that ball game. And then last Saturday night, played a very good football team at Saginaw Valley, and again, fell behind early in the ball game, and were able to fire it back up and come back in the third quarter and go up on them, and then ended up losing in a shootout over there. But it shows us kind of where we're at right now. I'm excited about where our football team is and where they can go. We still have a lot of work to do, and those are the things that we're working on right now.
That game against Hillsdale, home opener, season opener at Top Taggart Field on a Friday night. I know it was kind of unusual to play a Friday night football game. Talk about how your kids responded in that game and how they came back in that second half from a deficit.
Well, we played very physical football, and that was the big thing. And, you know, the first ball game of the season, there's always going to be some mistakes, and things aren't going to be as clean as what you want it to be. But, you know, the big thing is we got after them, and we didn't back down from anything and fell behind a little bit in the score. And the nice thing about it was full throttle. I mean, these guys didn't bat an eye. They came back, and they battled themselves back into that football game and came up with a win. And that, with that, there's a lot you can build from there. There's, you know, that character part of it and that intensity level.
We do have some highlights of that game, and I know first drive of the game, first drive of the season, your offense came out, you put some points on the board, a couple short passes to Mike Ryan, senior wide receiver, and then a touchdown from senior quarterback Tom Schneider. Talk about how your offense has played and being able to take care of the football over the first two games.
Well, job security is ball security is a critical part of this whole thing, and being able to hold on to the football, and we have not turned it over yet. We've been pretty consistent with what we're doing. We're trying to blend the run-pass game as much as possible. The first ball game, we ended up running the football a little bit more than we thought we might, and last week it was a little bit more to the air. But our guys are starting to get a lot more comfortable with our new system. Looking at where we've progressed since last year, it's a whole new thing. I mean, the details, the small things that we're trying to get accomplished, the guys have really got a grasp on it, and, you know, we're being pretty productive with it.
Hillsdale did come back and took a lead in that ball game, as we mentioned. Your guys came back at the end. Talk about the running game in the second half. Skylar Stoker named the GLIAC Player of the Week, 162 yards rushing, and the performance maybe of him and the offensive line in front of him.
Well, that's been great to see him mature as a football player. I mean, and it's all a learning curve, and now he's third year as far as carrying a football for us, and man, is he coming alive. You know, I mean, very powerful running, and runs with a lot of authority. He's a lot smarter running the football. He's setting up his blocks, and then when he hits the gas pedal, it's full throttle, and he's getting us extra yards. It's nice to see our offensive line. We're very athletic up front. You watch these guys get downfield and making football plays as you're 10, 15, 20 yards across the line of scrimmage, and that's exciting to watch.
It was a good defensive performance by your team as well in the second half of that game, a very talented Hillsdale offense, but your defense did a nice job of being able to stop them in the second half.
Yep. I mean, it's a situation, the way the ball spread out so much on the football field, you're not going to shut people out anymore in this day and age, but it's being able to keep people under control and bend, don't break, and they did a nice job responding to some of the drives, and again, you're playing a very veteran Hillsdale football team.
You go on the road, conference opener this past Saturday night at Saginaw Valley, a tough game, 30-27, went down to the wire. As we mentioned, a play here or there really could have changed the outcome of that game. But talk about your kids on the road, a hostile environment, 8,000 people there, and with all the extra activities going into that game, talk about how they performed.
Well, there's no question the intensity level Saturday night was very high. I mean, it's fun to play in that type of environment. I mean, a little hostile, but that's the way it is. You know, you kind of thrive for those opportunities. Our guys, they went to battle. I mean, we came out and we marched the ball and scored, and you know, we didn't back down from that football game at all. And unfortunately, we got ourselves behind a little bit with a couple of misfires and things like that in the second quarter, but then came out of the locker room and we got after it. You know, that third quarter, we totally dominated that football game. And then it got into a shootout at the end, and we had a couple opportunities that we didn't take advantage of. We had a drive that we were moving down in, and we should have got another score out of it, and a couple penalties kind of set us back a little bit. And next thing you know, we come out without points, and it came right down to the wire, and unfortunately, we lost in the last minutes of that football game. But again, you know, when I look at the character of our football team and the intensity that we played at, you know, that's going to help us win a lot of football games.
You mentioned earlier about Hillsdale coming back to beat Grand Valley. I know you've mentioned it before in the GLIAC, anything can happen from one Saturday to the next, and certainly that's been the case, at least through the first 2 weeks of the season.
There's no question about it. I mean, you really have to play your A game. You have to be right on. You have to take advantage of every opportunity in a football game. You know, everybody's so closely matched, you know, and you look at the different scores from the different teams, and, you know, it's just you better be ready. If you think you're going to show up and just be there and win a game, that's not going to happen.
You move on this week, taking on an Ohio Dominican team as you come back home for Agriculture Day at Top Taggart Field on Saturday night. Activities going on in conjunction with that game, but you're taking on an Ohio Dominican team that's maybe a little better than advertised, coming off a big win over Northwood.
That's a young football program, and they've invested a lot into that program, and the head football coach there was an Ohio State assistant for a number of years and recruiting coordinator, and actually was with ESPN for a while, and his forte is recruiting. And you look at that football team as it's developed, now all of a sudden you start seeing transfers pop into the lineup. And, you know, they're a better football team than they were a year ago. And last weekend they beat Northwood. And, you know, right now watching that and, you know, where they are level-wise, you know, we got our hands full again, you know. But I'm more concerned about ourselves each week and our preparation as we go through the week. And our guys are hungry. We're excited about taking on that opportunity and get back in the winning column.
Last year, Ohio Dominican's first year in the GLIAC, you went down to Columbus, Ohio, and took on Ohio Dominican, and it was a game that went to the wire. And, you know, this year they'll be making their first trip to Big Rapids. Talk about some of the keys to the game going into Saturday night.
Well, we just need to control the football. We need to control the football, and we got to get our offense clicking, and we need to take advantage of it, each one of those drives. You know, we came short on a couple drives last week, and we can't do that this week. And, you know, the defense is going to have to rise to the occasion. And, you know, it's all three phases of the game. You know, our special teams is much improved. You know, we still have some things that we need to clean up as we go into this football game, but we have to get all three phases of the game going, you know, to beat a football team like that.
Well, Coach, best of luck on Saturday night. We'll talk to you again next week.
Yeah, thank you.
When we come back, we'll talk Ferris State women's soccer with head coach Matt Kellogg. Stay with us on Ferris Sports Update.